this is Mike Lindsay from Vital MX. We're out here at Paris MX today with the Alta Motors crew. We've gotten the opportunity to ride their 2018 Redshift MX, which is the bike that is farther behind me, and the all-new Redshift MXR, the one that you can see closer to me. The Redshift MX is really based off the model they sold last year. There are a couple improvements, a couple things with the software. They were able to get a little bit more power out of it, change the output a little bit. The MXR, on the other hand, albeit it looks pretty similar, is actually quite different internally. Inside that casing, that battery pack is an all different version. All the electronics, a lot of the algorithms and the way it operates is completely different. The suspension is quite a bit better. It's a newer set of WP suspension, newer shock, the newer AER 48 air fork. Overall, what that produces on the track is a bike that the R stands up to. I guess I could term it as race. It's very competitive. I was very impressed. To give it a real blunt comparison, it's very similar to, say, a 350 motocross bike. It still doesn't quite have the output of a 450, but it is very comparable to around what a 350 makes. And the differences really are is electric motors produce 100% of their torque instantaneously, and that might sound like, okay, bike's gonna loop down in place. The amount of work they've done with the algorithms is insane. The bike does produce a ton of torque, but it's one of the most rideable motorcycles I've ever ridden for how it lays down the power, how it produces it, where there's more on tap and where there isn't. Yes, it is a little weird riding the bike without a transmission. That power is spread out over what I would consider a couple gears, not quite as wide as the range of a motocross bike. On the tighter track we rode today, it was more than adequate. On a bigger, more open national setting motocross track, I'd like to try it. I think there would be some points where you'd want to really start to play with the gearing for the really more open high-speed sections. This bike produces a lot of power instantaneously, and it just kind of builds at a very consistent rate. I would say riding it, I go back to some of the things you do on two-stroke. I feel like you get more of your momentum going before a jump. You don't do the four-stroke, like if you're playing around, you come up to a jump, bah, 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 and like you can gun it more in the face. This, you want to get more of your acceleration done earlier like you would on the two-stroke to have your speed set more when you get to the jump. The bike is very light feeling in the air. You don't feel like there is inertia finding you very often. Also, the way the bike lands, the way the algorithms kick in, it doesn't land. If it were to go 100% torque right when you land, you'd probably feel the bike try to loop back. It would try to squirt out from under you. This bike calculates really well right when you touch down to kind of feed you the power over a couple split seconds and taper in the input when you have when you land. Not enough that you feel like, you know, say if you land in a soft section, you feel yourself kind of lean forward on the bike as the bike gets sucked down. It's not quite that aggressive, but it's not, it doesn't allow the bike to just come out from under you as soon as you land. So it makes it much easier than you'd think to adapt to. I did have the opportunity to ride Darren Durham's bike a couple months ago for just a few laps. So the first thing I was able to get out of my head is what's really gonna shock people when they ride this. The noise, or the lack thereof, engine, the hearing the tires, the chain slap, the suspension, rocks bouncing off you, stuff that just, it starts to affect initially your ability to concentrate on riding. Once you wipe that all out though, the lack of a clutch, the lack of gear shift, the way the power outputs, it's a really fun motorcycle to ride because you're able to concentrate on other aspects. I found myself really working the bike out corners, really focusing on my foot position a lot. I have to move my foot less since I have no shifter. Just dealing with the brake pedal, being able to literally hear the tire slide to know how much rear brake I'm supposed to be applying. It allows you to focus on a lot of little things. There are certain aspects of this bike is, I will downright say, better at than a combustion bike. And there are a few aspects where I don't wanna say it's worse, it's just not what we're used to. It's kind of give or take situation a little bit. There are certain aspects with this bike that I really find helpful, things that allow me to focus on certain aspects of my riding and just really enjoy it. Ultimately, beyond just the initial impressions of riding the motorcycle, what else is really impressive is what Alta's been able to do price-wise. They were able to drop the price of the MX down to about $10,500 or so, and then the new MXR behind me is about another $1,500. Realistically, now it's a little over 10 grand and just under that $12,000 mark. That isn't much more than a 450. I mean, there's guys that go out there and buy a 450, do their suspension, their exhaust, they're right in the range of this. And for pretty much how little work you have to do to them, it's starting to make a little more sense. Sure, I know there's guys that are gonna look at this and shake their heads because it doesn't have the sound, the noise that they're used to, but riding's pretty darn fun. And this thing allows you to do a lot of riding you normally can't. There's a lot I can continue to talk about, so make sure you check out the article below. I'm gonna have a very long in-depth audio piece that's really more of my feedback on the bike itself. If you're watching us on YouTube, please scroll down and hit the link below to jump on our site, vitalmx.com, and you'll definitely get to learn a lot more about this motorcycle.